Welcome, Public Inventors. Now, how would we make such large, powerful objects? Well, instead of using little magnetic rods here, we would use the enormous hydraulic actuators, which are already used on bulldozers and backhoes to exert tremendous force. So you can imagine this shape, which happens to be a little fragile, built completely out of 12 feet long actuators, and it would have the power to exert enormous forces and hold up buildings or perform other functions or simply move into position and be strong enough for a car, a truck, or a human being to utilize it for some purpose. Now, this shape, the tetrahelix, is what we want to start with. But to actually build this, we have to pay a certain amount of money for each member. This would be fairly expensive to make. So, of course, we always want to do the simplest thing that we can that could work. And so here is a simpler tetrahelix. You can see that it's simply the same thing with more of the helixes removed. And you can kind of imagine that if we had this working, where each of these rods were something that could make itself shorter or make itself longer, which is what a linear actuator is, we would have an object that could move and potentially walk and move itself across the ground and then hold itself in position and be a strong space frame for either exerting force or simply holding itself in position. But this is not the simplest object. The simplest object is perhaps this object with all of the blue members removed, like this. So, as it happens, this is a very simple object. It consists of three tetrahedra stuck together, 12 actuators. I believe that if we made this, we would be able to walk. And if we could make this in a relatively inexpensive way that it could walk, we could make this, which would mean that eventually we could make this object, and eventually we could scale the whole thing up or down to different sizes to make large, relatively inexpensive polymorphic robots, or perhaps small snake-like robots, which would have the ability to turn and perhaps enter the human body and perform surgery or do some other value, if we could make the actuators small enough. Now, this three tetrahedra shape is something that I have actually constructed here. Now, of course, it's not clear because these actuators are not quite the same size, but this shape, which I call the three tet glusbot, is actually the same shape that I'm holding right here. And in the next video, you'll see this object walking and moving along the ground. So let me explain what this is. If you've seen some of my other videos, you'll see how it fits into that. This is a robot that consists of three tetrahedra that uses a commercial off-the-shelf actuator. It can make itself about this long, can make itself about this short. These cost $80 and are sold by a company called Fergeli. They're very reliable, very powerful, not very fast actuators, as you'll see. I am using a joint of my own design, which is 3D printed here. This is a spherical joint, which I call the turret joint. It was originally invented by three Korean gentlemen, Song Kwon and Kim. They may not be gentlemen, I don't know. They, I don't think, anticipated the idea of using a moving robot for their joint, but they did design the basic spherical joint with holes which allow multiple members to come together in a single point. I have little couplers to the Fergeli things, and I've 3D printed boxes to hold my control apparatus and my batteries. I use normal 12-volt nickel metal hydride batteries, which are powerful enough for these actuators. Inside here it is a Arduino Mega, which have a lot of pin controls, which is necessary because it is difficult to control 12 motors at the same time. These 12 actuators actually have to, in some cases, be coordinated. So I've got two controllers, each of which can control 6 motors. I was unable to find an off-the-shelf motor controller that could control 6 channels, so I designed my own a shield for the Arduino Mega. Inside here, there's an actual shield. That's open source. You can find it at Oshpark. It has uses three Pololu dual channel boards to control, apply voltage to the motors, and it has a little bitty Bluetooth module so that I can control both of them together with my Mac in combination with some software. So the system consists of the 3D printed spherical joints, 12 linear actuators, two Arduino Megas with two of my Arduino Mega shields, and a number of hardware components that are soldered onto the shield, the Bluetooth module, and the Pololu drivers. The total thing has a bill of material cost of about $1,300. As you will see when you watch the video of this walking, it's not particularly graceful. It's still at the early stages of development. It doesn't walk particularly well, but it does walk. And I believe this is a very important milestone in the creation of objects that eventually will look like this and can be scaled up to enormous size and enormous force, or even scaled down, and eventually could create something like this, which would be a instantaneously deployable bridge or rapidly deployable bridge or truss in a situation where a building needed it. And of course, it also opens up a lot of research possibilities. For example, my friend Robert Gatliff designed this shape, which is two icosahedra put together, and asked the question, well, if these could all move, could this roll? I certainly think it's possible. It's possible to build that shape with this same technology. It's also possible to build the doggy shape with this same technology. Now, why would we want to do those things when other people have already produced rolling robots and have already produced quadrupedal robots? Well, the advantage of this is that each of these things is built out of the same material. It's nothing but the joints connected by the rods, and you can form all of these configurations and program it. So instead of a robot consisting of many specialized components, all of these ideas, including even the construction of a large space-filling robot like this, can be constructed out of exactly the same material. So what you have is essentially flubber, in the sense that you've created a material which responds to your commands, which is homogeneous in its structure. So you don't have to say, I want a doggy robot, or I want a three tetrahedral robot. You could simply say, I want five tetrahedra worth of robotic material, put it together in any configuration you want, and control it all in the same way. Now, is that advantageous? Well, not unless the price can be driven down. But since all of these are the same, you have a highly modular, high economy of scale production of these components. So you can focus on simply making each of these individual joints and members as inexpensive and effective as possible, and open up the possibility to all of these configurations. And then you can imagine even crazier things like, well, I want the doggy robot, but I want to put a long tail on it. And you simply mount those together and adjust your software accordingly. And then you can do all kinds of things with very powerful, potentially very large, potentially relatively inexpensive robots. That is what I've been working on for the last 8 months.